Welcome again to my session, and today we are going to discuss about the muscles of the forearm, specifically the muscle that concerned with the pronation and supination of the forearm. We have three kind of muscles. The first one is called the supinator, that's concerned with the supination of the forearm, and the second group of muscles, we have the pronator teres and the pronator quadratus muscles. That pronator teres and the pronator quadratus muscles are concerned with the pronation of the forearm. Now, we are going to discuss about the origin and insertion, nerve supply and arterial supply of which muscles. By starting with the pronator teres muscles, the pronator teres muscles have two heads. As you see, there is a head that is started from the humerus, and there is a head that is started from the ulna bone. Now, the first head is called the humeral head. The humeral head is from the medial supracondylar ridge. The medial supracondylar ridge is immediately to the medial epicondyle of the humerus. That is the medial epicondyle of the humerus, where the first head of the pronator teres muscles is originated. And we have the second head. The second head is called the ulna head. The ulna head is comparatively small compared to the humeral head. The ulna head is from the medial side of the coronoid process of the ulna. That is the coronoid process, and that is the origin of the pronator teres muscles, which is the medial part of the coronoid process of the ulna. Now, let us see the insertion of the pronator teres muscles. The pronator teres muscles, all the two heads of the pronator teres muscle, which is the humeral head and ulna head, are inserted into the middle of the radius. This is the middle of the radius bone, which is the insertion of the pronator teres muscles. Now, the pronator teres muscles is supplied by the medial nerve. The medial nerve is responsible for the supply of the pronator teres muscles. And the function of the pronator teres muscles is the pronation of the forearm, and it is weakly flexes the elbow. That is the function of the pronator teres muscles. It flexes the elbow because it attached to both the arm and the forearm. Now, let us see a little bit about the clinical note about the pronator teres muscles. The pronator teres syndrome causes a wrist pain. Now, the patient may get the numbness in the median nerves and fail to pronate and the supinate the forearm. That is the clinical note about this muscle. And we have the pronator quadratus muscles. That pronator quadratus muscles, it is called the quadratus because it is the rectangular in shape or square in shape. You see that it is rectangular in shape, that is called the quadratus muscles, the pronator quadratus muscles. And the pronator quadratus muscles is the only muscle that is inserted into the ulna and radius bone. It is only muscle that has these characteristics, and it is supplied by the median nerves, and also it is supplied by the anterior interosseous nerve. And the blood vessel that supply this pronator quadratus muscles is called the anterior interosseous artery. So you are supposed to remember the nerve supply of the pronator quadratus muscles, which is supplied by the two nerves. The first one is called the medial nerve, and the second one is called the anterior interosseous nerve. And the arterial supply of these muscles is at anterior interosseous artery. Now, let us discuss about the supinator muscles. That is supinator muscles. The supinator muscles is antagonistic to pronator teres and the pronator quadratus muscles. This is antagonistic to the two muscles, and the origin of the supinator muscles is the lateral epicondyle of the humerus. You see, that the muscles, the supinator muscles, is originated from the lateral epicondyle of the humerus, and it is inserted into the lateral proximal radial shaft. That is a proximal radial shaft. That is the insertion of these muscles, and the nerve supply of these muscles is not the median nerve as compared to pronator teres and the pronator quadratus, but it is supplied by the deep branch of the radial nerve. The deep branch of the radial nerve is specifically responsible for the supply of the supinator muscles. Arterial supply is radial recurrent artery. The radial recurrent artery is responsible for the supply of the blood to the supinator muscles. That's all about the muscles of the forearm that's concerned with the pronation and supination of the forearm. But the addition is the function of supinator muscles. The supinator muscles in cycling the radius to supinate the hand. So it is responsible for encircling of the radius to supinate the hand. Suppose that the hand is at the pronated position like that, whereby the distal part of the radius bone is on the medial part of the body, and the distal part of the ulnar bone is on the lateral part of the body. That is the pronated position. Now, when the hand is at this position, the supinator muscles is responsible to encircling the radius bone in order to bring the hand into the supinated position like that. So it is antagonistic to the pronator teres muscles and the pronator quadratus muscles, which work together to bring the hand into the pronated position, but these supinator muscles work alone to bring the hand or the forearm into the supinated position. Thank you.